Now I am going to tell you what is a capacitor and how do we calculate the capacity of capacitor, and we will show you that capacitor of capacity 1 farad is not practically possible. Check how. So capacitor, capacitor is electrical conductor which can store electrical charge. It is a conductor which can store electric charge or electric energy. Right? The charge is stored by a capacitor Q is directly proportional to potential difference. So when you remove proportionality sign, you will get some proportionality constant CV. This C is called capacitance. So what is capacitance? Capacitance, it is an ability of a capacitor or conductor to store electric charge or electric energy. So this actually we will bring in measurement. So C is equal to Q over V. Q unit is coulomb and potential unit is volt. So this is called farad, and 1 farad is equal to 1 coulomb over 1 volt. So you can frame up a sentence. Undoubtedly, how can you frame up a sentence easily? The capacity of a capacitor is said to be 1 farad if it stores 1 coulomb of charge against a potential difference of V. Now if we look at this equation, it is a linear equation and you have to plot a graph between Q and V. This will be a straight line passing through origin. If you are able to measure this angle, then tan value of this angle is a slope that is equivalent to C. So you can also calculate capacitance by using QV graph. How do we calculate? Just by calculating the slope of the curve. Right? Let's see now. Capacitance of a spherical conductor. Capacitance of an spherical or isolated sphere. Capacitance of an isolated sphere. Consider a sphere of radius R carrying charge Q on its surface. Since it is a spherical surface, so entire charge can be assumed or to be concentrated at the center of a sphere. So any charge sphere you can consider as a single point charge, and this single point charge is concentrated at the center of the sphere O. So let's calculate potential at the surface of the sphere. That will be equal to 1 over 4 pi epsilon q over r, because we have concentrated charge at the center of the sphere. Therefore, capacitance C is equal to q over V. So this comes out 1 4 pi epsilon naught into R. That's what is the capacitance of an isolated sphere, charged sphere of course. Now see, if I say, for example, C is equal to 1 farad, then R is equal to 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught, that is 9 into 10 raised to the power 9, that is 9 into 10 raised to the power 6 kilometer, this is meter, that you can say 9000 into 10 raised to the power 3 kilometer. So if you want to achieve a spherical capacitor or an isolated sphere, uniformly charged isolated sphere which have capacity of 1 farad, you can imagine you have to have the radius of 9000 into 10 raised to the power 3 kilometer. Let me tell you here, radius of Earth is 6400 kilometer. So you can imagine whether you can make such a capacitor or not. It is very large capacitor. That's why I said that this unit of 1 farad to measure capacitance is very, very large. Is that clear? Let us see now principle of parallel plate capacitor. Means how do we make parallel plate capacitor? So take a uniformly charged and isolated metallic, insulated metallic plate. What I did? I have taken insulated metallic plate A, which is uniformly charged. Now, if you are getting confused, what do I mean with insulated and metallic? Metal is conductor, insulated, then what? It's a coating of insulation that you are seeing every day in day-to-day life. You have a live wire or wiring in your house which are connected from one point to another point. These all electrical wires are made up of copper, but these are insulated by paint and then plastic coating in order to avoid any shock. So this is a metallic plate, which is an insulated plate kept here. I can keep this uninsulated base also. Bring another insulated metallic plate which is uncharged. When you bring another insulated plate B, a negative charge is induced on a surface of plate B towards A. Positive charge induces on the other side of the surface. This negative charge will induce more positive charge on plate A. So it is completely get positive charge with additional. Now you just ground the outer surface of the plate B. When you ground, electron will move from ground to this plate B and neutralize this positive charge. Eventually, you will have two plates which is carrying, one is carrying positive charge, another carries negative charge, and you have obtained parallel plate capacitor. Let's calculate capacitance of parallel plate capacitor. Consider parallel plate capacitor having plates A and B. Plate A is carrying positive charge, plate B carries negative charge. Charge densities of A and B are plus sigma and minus sigma respectively. Electric field between these plates will be in between these two plates. Separation distance is small d. Small d is distance between plates. However, in parallel plate capacitor, at the edges you will find electric field lines are fringing like this, thoda sa curve ho rahi hoti hai. To avoid and minimize this curve, we have to keep distance between two plates as close as possible. Let's see, calculate this. We know from Gauss's law, we have derived there. Electric field between plates is equal to sigma over epsilon naught, that was independent of the distance of the point. Therefore, potential difference between plates, potential difference V is E into dy formula. So this will be sigma into d over epsilon naught. Correct. Therefore, capacitance of parallel plate capacitor by definition is Q over V. Q is sigma into A over sigma into D epsilon naught. Sigma is surface charge density, and as we know, surface charge density is defined as Q over A, amount of charge confined over unit area. So when we place Q, it is sigma into A, sigma cancels, C comes out sigma into A over D. So this is the formula for capacitance of parallel plate capacitor. On what factors does it depend? It depends on medium between two plates, epsilon naught is coming. It depends on area of cross section of each plate. It also depends on separation distance between plates. Now you replace air by some other medium, then for other medium, C will be equal to K epsilon naught A over D, where K is dielectric constant. So in some other medium I can say and write Cm dividing 4 by 3, equation 4 by 3, what you will get? Cm over C is equal to dielectric constant. So there are so many formulae we have given for your calculation of dielectric constant. We have defined dielectric constant in terms of the ratio of the force. We have defined dielectric constant in terms of the ratio of electric field, then ratio of potential difference, and now in terms of the ratio of capacitance. Let's see energy stored by capacitor. Only parallel plate capacitor is there. So when I write heading energy stored by a capacitor here, I mean with parallel plate capacitor. Now if you want to charge two parallel plates, what is procedure? Initially both the plates are uncharged, so you have to connect across some potential difference V. This potential source which is connected across it will transfer positive charge on plate A, negative charge on plate B, and hence capacitor will charge to its maximum strength. But it is not so easy. Why it is not so easy? When some charge initially is transferred by positive terminal to the plate A and negative terminal to the plate B, the transfer of charge for transferring next amount of charge to the plate A and B respectively, the source has to do more work. Somehow it has deposited that amount of charge also. So now charge is increased on plate A and B. So when you transfer more charge, it has to do more work, because every time the force of repulsion will increase. Right? So consider dQ amount of charge is transferred. Given to plates. So work done is dW is equal to V into dQ. That is Q over C dQ. Total work done, W is equal to integration Q over C dQ, 0 to Q limit, you will get Q square by 2C. When you place Q is equal to CV, you will get half CV square or half Q into V. These all are the formula for net work done or energy stored, because this amount of work done is stored in form of electrical energy. Now if you want to calculate expression for energy density, this is defined as amount of energy is stored per unit volume. So, how much amount of energy is stored per unit volume? Just check. We know energy stored is equal to half CV square. C is equal to epsilon naught A over D. And this is potential V is equal to E into D. Substituting these values here in equation 1, so what you will have, U is equal to half epsilon naught A over D, E square into D square, 1D cancels, that is half epsilon naught E square A into D. This is volume between two plates. So energy density sigma, you can say U over V, that is half epsilon naught E square. Let's do now two NCERT question. Question number 2.5, unsolved exercise. It says a parallel plate capacitor with air between plates has capacitance 8 picofarad. Calculate the capacitance if separation distance is reduced to half and space is filled with a substance of dielectric constant 6. So, in any medium, we know the formula epsilon naught A over D. So, now reduced D also as half dy 2. It comes out 2k epsilon naught A over D. And this you can see is capacitance of air. So, it is 2k Ca. Ca is given 8 picofarad, so 2k is given 6, it is 8 picofarad, so it comes out 4896 picofarad. Simple question. Now another question is 2.8. In parallel plate capacitor, air between plates, each plate is of area this and separation distance between plate is 3 mm. Calculate capacitance. Here you will use formula state epsilon naught A over D. Just to substitute value 885 into 10 raised to the power minus 12. Area is 6 into 10 raised to the power minus 6. Separation distance 3 mm. Converting into meter 10 raised to the power minus 3 meter. When you solve all, then you will get 17.71 picofarad. That's how you can calculate capacitance. Now second part says if capacitor is connected to 100 volt supply, calculate charge on each plate. So for calculating charge, we have formula Q is equal to C into V. C we have 17.71 into 10 raised to the power minus 12 into 100. This you can put it as 10 raised to the power 2. So charge is 17.71 into 10 raised to the power minus 10 coulomb, or you can put it as 1.77 into 10 raised to the power minus 11 also. When you continue in this NCERT exercise 2.9, this is a little more interesting. Question says, in the question 2.8, right, everything remains intact. What he said, what will be the capacitance and charge stored by the capacitor, means same things are calculated, while voltage supply remains connected. Or second case is when voltage supply is disconnected. So here I am giving you two hints. These will work very well, and thereafter you can use the same formula, there is no problem. Number one, when voltage remains connected, voltage supply remains connected, then what will be the constant? Voltage or potential difference across the capacitor will remain constant. It won't change. Second case, when voltage is disconnected or power supply is disconnected, in this case always charge remains constant. Charge on capacitor does not change. So first case is when voltage supply remains constant, so V remains same and it is given 100 volt. Now charge will be Q dash, you can take. C will be different because it says 3 millimeter dielectric constant is also introduced, additional. So this C, let's do it that side quickly. In 2 point, I am talking about exercise 2.9. Dielectric material of constant, how much? 6 is introduced. So C nu will be equal to K into of air, 6 into 17.71 picofarad. Right? So when you calculate this, it comes out nearly 106 picofarad capacitance. So now charge, new charge will be C nu into V old, it is not changing. So 106 picofarad into 100, so it will be 106 into 10 raised to the power minus 10 coulomb. Second case is when voltage is disconnected. When voltage is disconnected, then V will change. Q remains constant, so Q remains same. That is 17.71 into 10 raised to the power minus 10 coulomb. Voltage will change, so calculate voltage. Voltage, new voltage will be Q over C nu, that is C nu. This you do, and then you can easily work it out because it's small calculation. Apart from this, do exercise NCERT exercise 2.10. NCERT problem 2.10 also, right? And you can do for 2.4 for Gauss's law practice. For Gauss's law. So these exercises you have to do from NCERT.